Hey everyone, welcome back. I hope everyone had a wonderful holiday. I would like to wish everybody a very safe and very prosperous New Year. Now, let's go see Steve Hayes, the tired old queen at the movies, and get our New Year started off right.
Oh, quiet. It's just Johnny, come on.
Well, I guess you're a tired old queen at the movies.
Happy New Year, Johnny.
For New Year's, I thought I would take us to Africa. Down to Africa
with Clark Gable,
Ava Gardner, and Grace Kelly in John Ford's Technicolor,
MOGAMBO.
Now, this was a remake of a movie that Gable had made with Gene Harlow and Mary Astor in the 1930s called Red Dust. It was a pre-code movie.
What's the matter? Afraid I'll shock the Duchess?
There was a lot of sex in the jungle in this movie, so they thought, well, we'll remake this. It'll give us a chance to go to Africa. And they were doing at that point at the studios, this is 1953, and they were doing anything to get Americans out of their living rooms and away from their televisions. So they went on location to the Belgian Congo and they shot this picture. Now, Gable, at this point, was a little getting in a little bit long in the tooth, and taxes were eating up his money, so he began making more and more and more movies in Europe.
Peter, what's happened to us?
This gave Ava Gardner the best role she'd had in a long time. She had just done Showboat, Julie and Showboat, and she'd been a big hit. She was married to Frank Sinatra. That marriage was not going well. So she got to play this character named Honey Bear.
Well, her name is Kelly. Eloise Kelly, better known in the gay capitals of the earth as Honey Bear Kelly.
Gable and Ava Gardner had already made a couple of pictures together, and they were good buddies. They really, really got along well. Ava Gardner was a great, great gal, and besides being one of the most beautiful women ever, Elizabeth Taylor once said, I was just a teenager, and I took a look at Ava Gardner when she walked across MGM, and I burst into tears because she was the most beautiful thing I ever saw, and I thought my career was over. Ava Gardner just was this glorious girl. She photographed beautifully. They began building her up. Right away, she married Mickey Rooney. They were both teenage kids. That didn't go well. Then she married Artie Shaw, and that didn't go very well, and so she divorced him. Then she had a love affair with Robert Taylor while he was still married to Barbara Stanwyck. She was always a broad, a great broad.
Look, Mr. Whoever you are, let me jump to my own conclusions, huh?
Essentially, the story of this is that Gable is a big game hunter. He takes people on safari. He comes back, and there's this gorgeous woman, Honey Bear, who was supposed to meet this wealthy guy down, and they were all going on safari. Well, the wealthy guy took off, and she's stranded there. So she and Gable sort of take up, and they start sleeping together, and they're having a good time.
If you'll be so cooperative.
With pleasure, Miss Kelly.
Whereupon, this very, very British couple arrive, and it's Grace Kelly and her husband, and he's a scientist, and he wants to study gorillas, and Grace is doing her very Grace, you know, Grace, proper Grace Kelly thing, and the sparks begin flying between her and Gable, and pretty soon, they're doing it, and they're having a big affair. And he throws over Ava Gardner, and basically that's the story. And then it's whether or not Ava will take him back.
You know, your head would look pretty decorative over his mantelpiece. You know, with your big ears stuck out like an elephant about to charge.
And on top of this, you have all these animal scenes and, you know, Grace Kelly falling into a pit and almost getting eaten by a leopard. And Clark Gable saving her and kissing her against the high winds. And Ava Gardner just cracking one-liners, one right after another. She's great.
You know, this is no Sir Galahad who loves from afar. This is a two-legged
pony.
Arthur, you'll have to excuse me, but I left my cap and gown at the cleaners.
Oh, she's just great in this movie. And she got an Academy Award nomination for it. It was the only one she ever got, unfortunately. I don't know why. Audrey Hepburn won for Roman Holiday that year. And shortly after this, she and Frank Sinatra were divorced. Ava then decided she'd had it with Hollywood and the Hollywood lifestyle, and she went to Spain, and she fell in love with Luis Dominican, who was this great bullfighter, and they had this torrid affair, and she lived in Spain, and then she lived in Europe for the rest of her life. She finally died in London, and Frank took care of her a lot in the last years. He never really got over her. She was the great love of his life. And they interviewed her later and they said, why did you stay in London? And Ava Gardner said, because they let you get fat in London like an old whore and they leave you the hell alone. She was very good friends with Grace Kelly. Grace Kelly loved her. And Grace Kelly had this veneer of being the proper princess and stuff, and she slept with everybody.
You must forget that it ever happened.
She had, like, a love affair with Raymond Land. She had a love affair with Clark Gable during the making of this.
It was just... well, it was nothing.
You want me to forget it?
She had a love affair with Bing Crosby, and she with Jean-Pierre Aumont. She had an affair with Ole Cassini. I mean, she, you know, Grace was, you know, for a while the original good time girl. She was had by all.
You mustn't say that.
But this movie is so much fun, and it's Gable. She brings back the old Gable, you know. Gable always had that look on his face like, well, I don't know what you're going to do, but sooner or later you're going to wind up in bed with me. You know, he always had that look. He had it with, you know, with Scarlett O'Hara, and he has it with Ava. And Ava's whole look is, okay, you know, your place or mine. You know, she is just a game gal. Big, bold adventure. Technicolor. John Ford, a great director. It moves. It's got everything. It's got Clark Gable. It's got Ava Gardner. It's got Grace Kelly. What more do you want for the New Year's? MOGAMBO. Adventure. Okay, let's all go to the lobby. Grace went like this, and Ava went, oh, Frank's bigger than that. She was a raucous sort of gal. Delicious.